Greetings. There was a young man with a problem. He had thoughts and ideas that were bad. At least he began to feel bad when he was told his ideas were sinful. But then he began to listen to a different voice. Instead of listening to the voice of right and wrong, he began to listen to the voice of acceptance and tolerance. He began to listen to the voice of non-judgmentalism and moral relativism. And then he learned that many people had his same problem, his same feelings, his same ideas. He was not alone. He listened to the voice that said, "Accept yourself." He listened to liberal religious leaders support him and encourage him with, "God made you this way." They told him to join with others like him and demand their human right to be. He began attending marches and rallies to feel good about himself and his way. And as his group became bold, they began to gain political support. Their sin allowed them to have extra money, easy money, and money bought power and acceptance. And then he gained the confidence to speak out, to come out and declare his true self. And at the urging of his new friends, he would speak. He would be an example. He nervously approached the podium with his prepared declaration. His hands were shaking. His palms were sweating. This could end many friendships. It could cost him his job. And as he waited for the supporting applause to die down, he took a deep breath. "I am a thief. I take what I want," he said. "I steal because that is who I am. Don't you dare judge me, because you too, you know you have those thoughts. I accept myself now. I am a thief. I have learned this is who I am. You must tolerate me because I have no choice. God, if you believe in a God, God made me this way. And you cannot tell me different. I am a thief. I have had these feelings. I have known I was a thief since I was 2 years old." And the crowd erupted in applause. It was so liberating for them all to come out. Never again would they accept the word thief with derision. Never would they accept the word thief be called a crime. Never would the word sin be hurled at them without the reflexive retort of "religious bigot" being retaliated. It was the intolerant religious Puritans who caused such guilt for so long. But not now. The sin would be accepted and taught in universities. As part of occupational therapy, college students would be encouraged.
"Class, you have been told your whole life you are not a thief. By your bigoted and repressed religious parents, no doubt. But how can you possibly know if you are a thief until you take something that is not yours and try it? See how it feels to you. You have no way to know if you are a thief unless you..." And I hate to use the old painful word of the ignorant, "until you steal something."
And society began to dissolve at that point, though none of them knew it. Society began to demand a new job category be accepted: thievery. Society even began to persecute and prosecute people who insisted property rights meant thievery was wrong, a crime, a sin. Advocates of thievery began to claim thievery was a victimless crime, and moreover, an honest redistribution of ill-gotten gains. because anyone who claimed property rights was clearly an evil person themselves, though none could dare apply the term thief as a pejorative. If you had property, you must have stolen it, using the pre-liberation vernacular. And as thievery grew, thieves demanded the government extend all the benefits of a real job to thieves. Thieves wanted not just tolerance of thievery, they wanted acceptance and normalcy. They would argue, "How can my way of income be any threat to your job? Your job is your job. Leave me alone to have my own source of income." And the society that allowed thievery began its descent into chaos and oblivion. Let he who has eyes to see and ears to hear understand the danger of personal identification with sin. Because once the society had redefined the sin as an undeniable human right, as an unquestionable human freedom, they damned those trapped in the sin, and they damned their nation as inexorably lawless. Because once they changed sins to rights, the nation no longer had any grounds to pass any law to stop any behavior. Every sin imaginable soon began to appear at the public forum to demand acceptance. And the sins that came forward demanding acceptance are too evil to imagine. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.